Hey everybody, we're at CES 2014, Elric with Tekka Tomorrow. I'm with two gentlemen from Intel, and they're going to be telling us some brand new stuff about the NUC. So gentlemen, introduce yourselves to my fans so they know who you guys are.
Yeah, so I'm John Deathridge, the Director of Marketing for the Intel NUC team.
I'm Alan Clampett, I'm the Technical Marketing Engineer for NUC.
Right on. Yep. And you guys have some cool stuff to show, right?
That's right.
We hope so.
We know so.
You guys know so, come on.
Yeah, so we got three new SKUs that we're launching here at CES. We've been shipping this newer Haswell NUC here in Core i5 and Core i3 flavors here for about a quarter. And we're getting a lot of feedback from people that they would like to see the NUC with a 2.5-inch drive support. And as you notice, when you open up this box, you see the SATA header on here, and you say, well, we're not making very good use of that SATA header and this one here. And our response to that is SSDs find technology for performance and reliability. But we've also acknowledged that maybe we need to bring some SKUs to market from Intel that support those 2.5-inch drives. So that's what we're announcing here at CES this week. And so this is an empty shell of the chassis. I just wanted to open it up real quick and kind of show you what it looks like inside. If strip the threads there.
Oh, hey, when I'm trying to unbox stuff sometime, you should see it doesn't want to cooperate. I'll cut it and I'll be like trying to get it out. It's like, what's going on?
Yeah, so this is really similar to this. As you can see from the outside, it's pretty much, you know, the same. It's just a little bit taller. And that tallness really gives you that room for a 2.5-inch drive bay.
Oh, awesome.
Okay, and so you can put an HDD spinning drive there up to 2 terabytes, or you can put an SSD in there as well and maybe have that SSD in addition to the mSATA SSD. You could RAID the two. You could potentially do MST, you know, RST caching between an HDD and an SSD down on the board.
Any plans on using NGFF at all down the line with this?
Yeah, so we'll get there in just a minute. So
that's just been a big question that has been thrown out.
So next generation of product will be M.2.
Right on.
So current generation will continue to use mini PCI, but you'll see M.2 coming from us down the road.
And it's like it's up to 1 terabyte right now that you can get in those, right?
Through Samsung's new tri-level cache. Yes.
Yeah, exactly.
Technology's growing all the time.
Yeah, it sure is. So the three SKUs you can get from Intel now, they're all shipping. You got the Core i5 high-end, Core i3, and then we've also got this cool new Celeron SKU coming out here based on Bay Trail architecture. Yeah. And the reason we think this is cool is because it's going to allow us to hit a price point that was previously unattainable with the NUC. We've gotten some feedback from the press and various customers that say we love the NUC, but we'd sure like a more affordable version. Well, with this one, you can populate it with your HDD and get a similar configuration to the SSD one, but hit system price points fully configured without the OS, but everything else less than $200.
Wow! And then how about for the top of the line model? What will that one be coming to market?
Depending on how you load it, right? You're probably system price point once again in the 600. Plus range, and probably in the for the Core i3, maybe in the 450 plus range.
Now, do you guys? I know you guys have like been really dabbling a lot, like in doing like video technology. Do you guys have plans at all of your own, like to like even do more high end video stuff and implement it in these type of machines in the future?
Talking graphics here?
Yes, yeah. Graphics.
So this version here will have HD 5000 graphics, which is just one stage short of hitting Iris, right? And Iris and Iris Pro are the premium graphics from Intel. You can get versions of this type of form factor from Gigabyte today that do support Iris Pro. And we've actually been showing that off here at CES as well.
So some of your third-party vendors actually have these then?
Well, I would call them more of an ecosystem partner.
Okay.
And so Gigabyte has their product line called the Bricks, which is very similar to the NUC, same type of technology, same category of product. And
isn't pretty much all the stuff that's inside of the Bricks, though, pretty much just your technology just inside of their box?
Well, I would say the board technology is very similar. I would also say that Gigabyte's done a fine job of innovating around the chassis, and their system expertise has brought a lot of value to the table. That's really how the ecosystem works, right? We make each other better. Maybe we provide some things.
Feeds innovation.
They provide some things. We help each other along, and the end result is a better product for our customers.
Right on.
Right? And so these are the three new products coming from us now. And
another question, what's the maximum memory that a person can update these to?
16 gigs.
16 gigabytes, okay.
Yeah, so two DDR3 1600.
Okay. Yeah. Yep. And so, and I believe this one has one slot on it.
It has one DIMM slot, so you get up to 8 gigs.
8 gigs on the entry level, 16 gigs on the two premium level products.
Right on. What you got back here?
Well, this is something for you to actually play with. It is actually that which you see there populated with the exception of memory. So you get to pick your own memory. So what you actually see in this...
it's an unbagging, folks.
I will do a deboxing and opening up
here. All right, check this out.
You can actually see what we actually put in there for your treats.
Unbagging, disassembly.
Yeah, there's actually a way you have to do once you actually get the cables connected to actually easily remove the hard drive tray. And we'll actually get this all shown here.
What, no auto tool?
Well, it's a Kingston HyperX.
Ah, David Young will love you. David, we love you, you know that.
Matter of fact, one of his guys, Louis K. Nishiro.
Ah,
I don't know if you know him.
I know him all, yeah.
Yep, so there you go. That is the actual Intel SSD. It is the 530 model, and it is the 240 gigabyte in size. Now you can actually see we actually have a daughter card here, which it actually slides into. I don't know if you can catch that. And then the other thing is right there.
Yep.
And then you have one screw there and one screw there to actually retain the actual hard drive or SSD. Then to actually to get below this with the cables like this, if you're trying to pull it out, this cable will actually kind of latch onto here and stop it from getting out. You just pop it up like that, and then we'll.
Real easy.
So the drive actually pulls out completely before you got to even try to remove.
Yeah.
SSD drive. Oh, that's perfect.
And then we also put in there one of our top-end Wi-Fi cards. It's the 7260 AC module.
Yep. And so just put the memory
in and away you go.
That's right. So if you
that means I got to walk around the show and bug somebody for some memory right now. Hey, I need
memory.
So I go back to my hotel and film
that's
it.
Right.
Exactly.
Kingston will be the guy I'll go visit.
We've told the other press that, hey, just go do that.
Yeah, that's what we're going to go do. So we'll go around with our little mini box and we get some
fired up in the room tonight.
There you go. That's what we'll do.
Yep. So another thing to mention, in previous generations of NUC, we have not shipped with power cords, and people have gotten a little annoyed by that. So all production versions of the NUC today now ship with power cords.
Big smiles, everybody.
Multiple countries are supported, so.
Like Smile and Bob.
And the other thing to make note of that, so you just have we use the standard power brick that we've done, since we started. Well, now we have the different power cords with the different connectors on the end, right, for the different geos.
Ah, cool.
Well, with this one right here, we're going to start out with the wall wart.
The Celeron model?
Celeron model is going to have a wall wart. It's only a 35 watt because it's the basically lower power, right?
Yeah,
so we don't have to do the 65 watt we have with this one. But it actually has all the different geos connectors. So you basically slide off a cover, slide on whichever connector you actually need for US, EU, UK, whatever.
And even the Celeron version, though, folks, even though it's a really low energy model, it's fine for people who are like checking their email, just doing Word stuff. It's perfect for all.
You can do 1080p video on it as well. Yeah. So entry level home theater PC would work.
So you have a whole solution that's basically no bigger than your hand, and that's what really the big thing about NUC is that you can take it pretty much anywhere, put it on your desk without taking up any real estate, and get high power in a little box.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Very well said. You're hired.
All right. Thanks. Thanks, folks. We'll see you guys back here for more videos at CES 2014. See ya.
Yeah.
Somebody's rudely calling me at the same time.